Hyundai New Zealand are proud to take you to Cardiff for Wales versus the All Blacks.
The All Blacks and Wales first played each other at the Millennium Stadium in Cardiff in 2002. And on that day, with current All Blacks Kevin Mialamu, Ali Williams and Tony Woodcock on debut, the All Blacks were big winners, 43-17. And since that match, they've met a further six times in this outstanding stadium. And every time the All Blacks have been successful, to the point where the winning sequence overall stands at 24 since Wales last won at the Old Arms Park in 1953. Welcome to Cardiff and the stadium where the roof is closed and these two proud rugby nations look to go into battle for the 29th time since the controversial start 107 years ago when Wales won by 3-0. Yes, an indoor stadium, some concerns about the turf. We'll have to wait and see how that pans out, but a capacity crowd is always when the All Blacks are here, of 72,500. And the crowd in great voice, as they always are, even though Wales' form leading into this match has been very average indeed. Okay, before the two teams come out, let's have a look at them. And the withdrawal yesterday of Dan Carter was a big setback for the All Blacks, but Aaron Cruden has shown in the past that he's very much up to international class. In fact, he's starting for the fifth time this season. Apart from Carter, the same 15 that demolished Argentina and Del Plata in their most comprehensive win of the season. And for a number of players, Israel Dagg, Julian Savia, Luke Romano and Cruden, this is their first experience of a test match in Cardiff. Richie McCaw plays Wales for the 10th time, captains the All Blacks for the 78th time in a test match. And like the All Blacks, Wales lost a key player yesterday in the form of giant winger George North. This means a start for 21-year-old Liam Williams. A big plus is the return at centre of the influential Jonathan Davis. He'll combine there once again with the powerful Jamie Roberts. The key man back in the forwards, experienced hooker Matthew Rees, the former captain, has been a regular starter against the All Blacks in recent years. And Sam Warburton sat on the bench for Wales' loss to Samoa last week, and he'll resume the captaincy as well. And to the benches, both sides have some firepower and experience on the bench. Bowden Barrett was under an injury cloud earlier in the week, but he's able to take his place on the reserve list after Carter's withdrawal, while for Wales, a couple of gnarly old veterans to call on in the form of Gethin Jenkins and James Hook. So once again, eight on the bench, and you've had a look at the 15 who will be starting in each team. It's all set up, and the players will be out with us very shortly. And Justin Marshall, this is some place, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is. Welcome, everybody. This is some place. And thankfully, the innovation of putting a roof on a place where it rains a lot was a stroke of genius, because it's very wet outside, has been all week. But it's not here, as you can see. This is a glorious stadium. A lot of optimism around Wales about whether or not they can beat the All Blacks. But being in a team where you are suffering some adversity and the chips are down, the only thing you can do is come out fighting, and I'm sure Wales will do that. And if they do, we're in for one cracking test match.
As always, plenty of Kiwis here. Not all of them live in Wales. Plenty of them living in England across the border, of course, have come down for this international, which is the third after the All Blacks beat Scotland 2 weeks ago, Italy and Rome last week. Now it's Wales, and of course they'll finish up with a test match against England at Twickenham next Sunday morning, New Zealand time. Tony Johnson is sidelined for us this evening. G'day, Tony.
Yes, Bo, as always, the atmosphere here is magnificent. There's been a massed choir of about 100 men out leading the crowd, getting them into good voice, and can't wait to hear the national anthem. You mentioned the pitch. They've put an awful lot of work in to try and improve the surface here, which hasn't been good in the past. There seems to have been a lot of coring going on. They say that the grass is a bit more deep-rooted than it's been in the past, and it may not cut up so badly. So let's just wait and see. But boy, what an atmosphere here. It really is an incredible stadium. And they will urge Wales on to try and do something that they have not been able to do for almost 60 years.
Fair bit of pessimism around Wales, it's got to be said, after their successive losses to Argentina and Samoa. But this is a match against the All Blacks, the old foe. And here comes Richie McCaw. And the All Blacks out into this unbelievable atmosphere. Test number 115. The great Richie McCaw, captaincy for the 78th time. A number of these players have been here before, but there are a handful who will be experiencing this for the very first time. And it is some experience before the game even gets underway.
Oh, it certainly is. The build-up and anticipation that the Welsh public and crowd have of their team bursting out onto the field. And it is an environment with a closed roof, as you mentioned, capacity crowd, that can be quite intimidating. But I'm sure with the experience the All Blacks have got out there, Richie McCaw has already got them in a huddle, and Warburton will lead them out to a boisterous reception, and the All Blacks will welcome that. They'll accept that challenge. It's a great experience as a youngster. You thrive in this atmosphere.
So the experience had amongst the All Blacks, just keeping a lid on things. Emotions can be very high. Young Beauden Barrett, well, earlier in the week, really wasn't considered because of a rib problem. But with Dan Carter's withdrawal yesterday, Aaron Cruden's promotion to the top 15, Barrett will sit on the bench now, Wales. It's got to be said, wonderfully loyal fans, the Welsh. Losses to Argentina and Samoa, and you still get a greeting like that.
Absolutely magnificent, isn't it? The fireworks were going off indoors. A special moment, and one to come up with the national anthems of both teams, New Zealand and Wales, should be spectacular.
Oh.
fantastic as always.
Well, I love our national anthem to bits, but I tell you, there's something about the way they do that that sends a shiver down your spine. But we've got something pretty special of our own as well, the haka, and that sends a shiver down the opposition's spine.
Okay then, let's stand by for the haka.
How will Wales respond? Last time they gathered and they came forward and they met it front on. They looked determined.
Different crowds react in different ways to the haka. In places like France and Italy, they watch and listen in silence. Places like Wales and England, it is slightly different, it's got to be said. So the All Blacks in a little huddle down by their own 22. Wales are set to go. And this really could be a spectacular game. Warren Gatland, of course, back in charge of Wales after being on Lions duty for the last couple of weeks. Now both teams almost ready. Craig Joubert is our referee. From South Africa, there he is, Jerome Gasset of France and Greg Garner of England are the assistant referees in the game. Rhys Priestland has the ball, and the 29th meeting of the All Blacks and Wales is underway, and the ball falls for Martinonu early on. And the ball pushed away for Cruden, hands it on. And Luke Romano, good strong ball carrier that he is, worked away again by Smith, and now the kick made by Cruden. And getting there is Corey Jane. He had to wait. Ball taken in nicely, and now Wales have some possession. And flicked away by Paul James, the loose head prop. Now Mike Phillips, the big halfback. Here's Toby Faletau, the Tongan-born number 8. 5 metres on his own side of halfway. And there's a player down in back play. And it could be the Welsh number 4, or lost by Julian Savia. Referee's got the arm out, and he's waiting for some advantage. And he's got to play the scrum now. Now there's some concern away, way back, with one of the Welsh players here, number 4, is it Bradley Davis?
Yeah.
And one of the props going down, I think, in sympathy.
Well, there's where it happened there.
Oh, he's been taken out by Sam Whitelock. Taken out high, and it's very dangerous the way he's landed. Well, that's not good. I don't think they can do anything about it now because it was never seen in real time. Yes, they'll see it on the big screen, but that's irrelevant unless they saw it. It's actually Andrew Hoare, and he's just stiff-armed him around the top of the head and got him flush on the jaw. Sorry to Sam Whitelock, obviously I've got the wrong guy, but whoever it was, and we've just seen now it's Hoare. That's not great, TJ.
No, it just seemed to be something out of nothing, but you could tell that he'd been hit. But when he went down, it looked like he was actually knocked out. He was prone for some time. He's actually getting back to his feet now. Well, it's certainly been a hot topic, and we're going to see this again and again on the replay. Been a hot topic, the judiciary, this week, but I get the funny feeling the All Blacks are going to have another appointment next week.
Well, you heard the call there. Aaron Jarvis is coming off. It looks like the tight head prop is going to be out of the game after just a couple of minutes. So there's concern on both sides of the field.
Well, do we have the concussion rule in play here?
I didn't see anything either.
I'm sure we do.
So Davis can come off without it suffering. Obviously, he can come back on once he's been assessed because he's definitely suffering from that.
Aaron Sinclair is coming on in 19. For Aaron Shingler, I beg your pardon.
Oh, yes, you saw there Aaron Jarvis. He's just a new boy on the block and just his second test match, reeling away. Oh, look at the pain there.
Well, they got the stretcher for him, so this is going to be a bit of a delay. It's sort of taken away, I guess, from the inspirational stuff with the Welsh and New Zealand national anthems and then the haka and then a good start, I think, from Wales. I remember last time here they linked arms, fronted the national anthem and then proceeded to kick the ball deep into the All Blacks. As you can see, that's a really nice touch. Richie McCaw just going to give him a pat, making sure that he wishes him well. And they'll ring the changes and really passively approach the game. They've started it with a bit more innovation. Switch kickoff, got themselves into the game in good position here to launch the scrum from.
Scott Andrews from the Cardiff Blues is the replacement, wearing jersey number 18.
Come up to the mark.
One of the two props, of course, on the bench. Gethin Jenkins being the other. So two replacements in there at the moment. We'll have to see one of them is temporary or not.
Closer together, please. Yep. So we'll make the mark there.
So the big 17 stone, you called it the other day, Nisbo. Winger Cuthbert on the inside of Priestland here. Now they've got Cuthbert, who is a genuine whopper. They've got Davis and also Robert. So they've got plenty of options for Priestland. He just needs the quality scrum ball to launch these big backs at Cruden. He'll go in that channel. Cruden and Smith.
Let's see how the scrum holds up. First up, they get a penalty. And it's a penalty against Tony Woodcock. Putting his hand on the ground. Well, he made his debut here for the All Blacks, Tony Woodcock, in 2002. And today, test number 95. Now, Priestland is going to kick for touch here. So the attitude of Wales becomes obvious early.
Oh, very early, because it's well within Lee Harpenny's range. He's notably a long kicker of the ball, so they've turned that down just because they want to take this game to the All Blacks. Wise move, I think. They've got to show some intent.
Warren Gatland, true to his word, he said before the game, you want to beat the All Blacks, you've got to go hard at them. You've got to take a few chances, and that's exactly what they're doing.
Matthew Rees, back in the Welsh team, the veteran hooker, throws to the line. Nicely dragged down by Charteris. Now, can they get something going? The All Blacks are nice and low and have held it up here. The Wales are going to free this. Held in the back by Shingler. Now they do get a little bit of way on. Swirling around, turnover ball.
That's more use or lose.
Well, it's all very well to drive it, but eventually you've got to free it up.
Yeah, that was poor from Mike Phillips. He had the opportunity there when he could sense that Romano was right there to just snatch that ball and clear it. He opted to hold on, as you can see.
Hey, once he's come through,
Jarvis making his way on stretcher up the tunnel. Really unfortunate for him. But yes, I think Phillips needed to get rid of that. He went to grab it and then all of a sudden pulled away, and from there the All Blacks have shut it down.
Well, it's something the All Blacks have done well all year, defend the driving ball. Not too many teams have been able to advance against them.
Stand up, please. You can't go head to head. You make sure you're inside. You're the tight end. There's Mark, come in closer, please.
So Scott Andrews is
come right up to the mark.
The replacement on this near side. No, just his fourth cap, replacing Aaron Jarvis, who was playing in just his third test.
Crouch.
So not a lot of experience on the tight end side of the scrum for Wales.
Touch. Set.
Smith gets it in. Now here's Reed. And Kieran Reed runs it out towards centre field.
Okay, all right,
Smith
all right.
Sets it up. And a good towering punt downfield by Aaron Cruden, who really only found out yesterday that he was to be involved in this test match, although it has to be said there was doubt about Dan Carter for most of the week.
Come in, Red.
So Reese throws again. Nicely delivered here by the new man, Shingler. Jane in the air. Bit of a collision. And this ball is still in play. And Israel Dagg just shepherds it across the line.
Well, again, good innovation from Wales. That was 100% on. Priestland's actual timing and length was very good. It just needed to be lower because the transition time gave Corey Jane a chance to push forward and shut it down.
All Blacks go quickly. Romano delivers. Smith kicks. Oh, that's an early jump. He never really got anywhere near that. Liam Williams running in from the left wing side. But it might have worked out okay. And another penalty. This one's a lot further out. So if there's any consistency in the game plan, they'll kick this out as well.
Well, it would make the first decision absolutely debacle. Yeah, would make it silly because, oh, here we go.
Oh, hang on, has it gone out?
But that's even worse.
Oh, that's terrible.
Oh, it's dead.
It is dead, yep. Oh, the man with the flag put it up and I thought, hello, he's going to go back to the 5 metre mark.
Good Greg.
No, that's just a fundamental error.
Well, those are the sorts of things that can just take the sting out of a team. They've got the crowd all fired up every time Andrew Hall goes near the ball. They're booing him.
Not such a big gap.
Temperatures are up, but a mistake like that just takes some of the sting out of the tail.
Now, it would seem, Tony, that Bradley Davis might have been permanently replaced. I think the 5 minutes might be up by now.
There's certainly no sign of him.
Okay. So Smith works it away for Cruden. And Halfpenny waits for this. Conrad Smith's there too. Good battle. Smith won it. The All Blacks have it. And Aaron Smith hands it up to Sam Whitelock. And the big number five, almost down to the 22, still working the blind side with Reed as the All Blacks attack really for the first time in the game as Nonu works it across to Romano. Bit of a tentative run by Luke Romano. But he finally gets as far as the 22. Now here's Cruden stepping his way through. Slipped the pass nicely. Whitelock again receives the ball. Now they work it away. Cruden turns it back inside. Savi has got a cross from the left wing side. And Aaron Smith. That's a better run by Luke Romano going in really hard.
Romano's coming, slowing the ball down.
But the penalty against Wales.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a long one for me. That was seven.
Red, folding
seven
over,
at least
the ball down.
At least seven phases. That's plenty of chance. Anyway, it was excellent work from Conrad Smith. He chased that kick from Kruder, which was an interesting tactic. He took it way forward and then kicked. You can see Conrad Smith wins it, spins around really nicely, and then places the ball out. There you can see there, they were all over the top of that Wales. Jamie Roberts is just lying on top of the ball. From here, the All Blacks go and get their hands on the ball. Interesting to see the centres coming up really quick, getting in Cruden's eye line. You saw him turn back in there two or three times because the centres are cutting off the outside channels for him.
Now, you mentioned Jamie Roberts there. He was the man who tried to stop Luke Romano just before the whistle went. Boy, he felt that.
Unlike the Welsh, the All Blacks will try and take the points on offer early in the game. First kick for Cruden is straight down the centre. 3 points to nil, the All Blacks lead.
All goes back to that touch finder from the penalty that didn't go into touch.
Priestland, he's been under a real cloud this season, just hasn't been able to recapture the form of last season, as Smith makes a wobbly kick downfield, but effective enough. 10 minutes gone, first half.
Short line out for Wales. Jones and Faletau out in the back line.
He's got some big targets. That's been beautifully taken. Rolling an extra couple of metres. Now the replacement, Scott Andrews, makes some good ground. Shingler. Now Roberts hits it hard. Snapped up by Cruden. Now Nonu, as the All Blacks look to counter-attack. Here is Conrad Smith busting out of one tackle. That of Jonathan Davis. Aaron Smith for Cruden. Whitelock. Here is Massam, All Blacks with numbers. Romano, somebody needed a straighten, and Luke Romano did so. 5 metres on the Welsh side of halfway.
No, two!
Smith again. And Cruden drops it onto the left boot, and it's a beauty. No real chance for Cuthbert. He wasn't quite sure where the touchline was. And he had to run it over that touchline.
Well, he had to let it go, is what he had to do. He wasn't 14. Really under that much pressure.
Just put the ball down.
If he'd let it go and it had bounced out, no problem. Could have gone out in the full even better, but that's not good enough. The mistakes continue. Turned over from a driving line out, missed touch. And there, Jamie Roberts spilling the ball. Wales.
Ball throws right at the back where Whitelock. Here's Nonu on the charge. Pretty good defence in the end by Priestland. It was a brave tackle, had to be made. Now Cruden, dag, good spot tackle by young Liam Williams, and that is well received. He only got the call yesterday when George North had to pull out of the game.
Boy, he had to make it though. If Dag could have got that free, they were gone down the outside. You can see the player unmarked. There he is, Corey Jane. He was gone. Well done, Williams. He comes in, boom, far, he knocks Dag over, forces him to make the mistake.
Come up and well, his speed off the line was crucial. He got up so quickly in his face.
Okay, don't go back, Wales. Crotch. Touch. Sit. Use it.
Well, the All Blacks managed to somehow just screw that awkwardly enough to gain a put in. And this really is an outstanding attacking position for them.
I rule it through 90. Well, set up left, up and left.
What's a blind trick?
To the left.
Crouch. Touch. Sit. Advantage.
He's got an advantage here.
early.
It's only a free kick, though. The Owls were pretty happy about their scrum there, and so were a lot of the crowd. And I think the All Blacks, another going to go. Here's Reed. Goes quickly, gives it off to the skipper. McCaw crunches down right in centre field. Now Aaron Smith off to Messam. And Liam Messam will set this. Charging on goes Hoare.
Onside here, Reed.
Now they go wide for Conrad Smith. Savia, danger time, and they get to him. Julian Savia looking to add to the 10 tries that he scored already this year, but this is good defence. Big line-out throw here, and quick deliveries. Phillips gets it away, and rolling is Warburton. They've done this well, Wales, if they can clear this effectively. And they can do, although, yes, it is out. Savia can still go quickly, and he does. Off it goes to Dagg. Now Jane in a bit of space. Corey Jane flicks it away to Conrad Smith. And the All Blacks well and truly inside Welsh territory again. Romano could see the Welsh defence coming up, dropped it behind him, snapped up by Franks. And Owen Franks, a bit outnumbered. And turnover ball. Now Wales with another injured player down as Jane brings that one under control. Gives it off to Dagg, and here they come again on the counter-attack. Savia in a bit of space and busting the first tackle. And hard to put away. Gets all the way to halfway, Julian Savia. Now Aaron Smith. Wide it goes. Here's Jane once more. The little kick and chase, but it's off the side of the boot. And another Welsh player.
It's Jamie Jamie Roberts, who's gone down. He's taken a fairly hefty bang on the hip by the look of it. Wales have taken it quickly.
Here they go again. And the kick by Phillips downfield.
Not a good one.
Fielded by Dagg. Now the counter-attack coming again. Savia back in position. Oop. Got rid of Ryan Jones.
They got rid.
With a pretty savage prod.
Use it. Cut.
In the meantime, Roberts still being attended to. Dagg. And Jane goes up. And the ball goes back. And hacked ahead. In a messy piece of play by Liam Williams. In the meantime, Roberts is up gingerly.
I think Israel Dagg wanted that kick to go out to where, or somewhere near where Jamie Roberts was being attended to. He's not good. He's not good.
He's going to hang on for the moment anyway. As Cruden drills one in behind Halfpenny. And it sits up nicely for the little fullback. And he's got a good boot on him too. And down it goes to Dagg. And the All Blacks through Cruden. Now Jane again. Again the little kick and chase. And Jane goes down in a bit of a heap. And he's won the penalty.
Red players in front of the kick advisory.
And in fact, he's got the Welsh players for offside, so it wasn't necessarily the obstruction on Corey Jane. And Jamie Roberts, well, he left the field against Argentina a couple of weeks ago. Well, he did get a bit of a shoulder there. But the upshot is another penalty.
Yeah, that hip's really causing some problems here for Jamie Roberts. He started to run and then he just turned around to the sideline. Despair all over his face at the moment. I think he realises that he's not going to be able to carry on for much longer.
That's a pretty good replacement. Is it James Hook might come on, Tony?
22, yep.
Yeah, I think it's going to happen. In the meantime, Aaron Cruden.
In fact, Scott Williams is coming on, so I guess this means they might bring one of their three quarters into the centre position.
Here's Cruden's kick. Just staggered over Another penalty, 6 points to nil.
I think they'll just put Williams at centre and Davies will go to 12. He has played there for the Scarlets before, so that shouldn't change too much. But obviously, Roberts is a massive loss in experience.
So three Welsh players off the field and only 18 minutes gone as Liam Messam runs it up towards the 22. Smith back to Cruden, and the charge coming from Mike Phillips, and it was good enough for Aaron Cruden to miscue it, and there's the damage. Jamie Roberts
sitting alongside Gethin Jenkins on the bench. I think a lot of people would be surprised to see him there, Jenkins.
So Reese throws. Good line-out work by Warburton. Now Priestland. And the new man, Scott Williams. Good run by him. Bit of momentum. As Ryan Jones takes it in. Now Faletau. Tongan-born number 8. Phillips again brings it out. Now some good running ball here. As Davis almost handed off Andrew Hoare, but the ball knocked free. And Hoare has it.
Onside work.
And Smith works it back, and the kick this time made by Dagg.
Well, Justin, I was going to say, now Ryan Jones isn't looking too good.
Well, it's enterprising from the Welsh. They certainly are, and you can see that by the carnage out there, throwing their bodies into it, but the New Zealanders are equally as physical, and they're just battering them. The problem for the Welsh is that they're just spilling too much ball. They've conceded penalties. And the architects of their own demise at the moment, their ill-discipline with the ball is proving costly. New Zealand haven't really thrown a lot at them, but are comfortably controlling this game.
Former captain jogs back into position. I think there's a few former captains in this team.
It's interesting strapping, Nisbo. You ever seen strapping like that?
No.
Must be a cut.
So Reese throws. Phillips gives Faletau on the charge once more. Good tackle, though, by little Aaron Smith. Wales through Shingler, the replacement player in the middle row, replacing Bradley Davis. Got to use this very quickly. It's the 5-second law, of course. Experimental law it is. Now it's turned over. So Smith works it away. Reed, here's Nonu on the charge. Busting his way downfield, Ma Nonu, 5 metres in Welsh territory. Now Smith hands off to Savia, and the big winger. Smith's got it back. Aaron Smith, Nonu stays at first receiver. Romano to fellow Lock, Whitelock. Welsh defence pretty sound. Cruden for Dagg away to Woodcock. And turnover, no. Sam Warburton thought he'd done everything right. Well, he accepts the decision. Some reluctance, no doubt. Let's see whether he's the tackler. I think that was his argument.
Yeah, he looked okay, didn't he? There he is there. There's the tackle there. Boy, that's a rough one. It's a rough one. And the crowd have just seen it on the big screen, and rightly, they should feel a little bit peeved about that, because I think he was perfectly fine. Don't you?
Yep, I think he was, actually.
It didn't look like he played any role in getting the man to the ground, maybe from the angle that he saw it from, Craig Gebert thought he had. Just a word about the pitch, guys. I know they've put a lot of work in, but it's already showing signs of cutting up quite badly in places. Just the surface being scuffed up, particularly where there have been scrums.
So Cruden looking to land his third penalty, and he does exactly that. Aaron Cruden, Dan Carter applauds. So three penalty goals. The All Blacks being clinical at the moment, leading by 9-0.
And clinical's the key word. They've had their chances and they've kicked their goals and they're ticking the scoreboard over. The Welsh opted for the lineouts, made mistakes and haven't got any points. Here's the difference, that ruthlessness of the All Blacks.
Priestland goes short. Good option. Beautifully done, though, by Jane. And he got the pass away as well.
Use it!
Well, there for Smith. He's got to do it quickly. And this kick is not going to gain a lot of ground. Big commitment made by Liam Williams. And it did go backwards. And Wales again. As Priestland drills it across field. And it's a very good kick indeed. The All Blacks probably won't throw this as quickly as in the past. And that's a bit of a confidence booster for Rhys Priestland. Now, there was absolutely nothing wrong with that. What was Owen Frank supposed to do?
Exactly, I agree. There's nothing wrong with it. He shows some commitment, Liam Williams. He's not gathered them, but he's gone in with some good intent.
Quick ball again as the All Blacks running it out from near their own line in the form of Nonu, Aaron Smith, and Cruden. This won't go out. So Alex Cuthbert, this big right winger, delivers the pass quickly to Lee Halfpenny. And Halfpenny tracking across field, realised he had to straighten. Good timing by McCaw. But Wales still have it. Here's Priestland again. Once again, Cuthbert, who stayed in the action. Now Scott Andrews, the prop forward. Mike Phillips falls over the fallen player. I think he's trying to milk a penalty there. Hasn't sort of worked out. A little tussle going in off the ball. Now Phillips away for Priestland. This is going to be another high kick, a searching kick.
It's a good one.
Savia and Halfpenny, and it bounces nicely for Dagg. He spins out of a couple of tackles, and he's broken clear, Israel Dagg. Now Savia, he's in the clear, Savia. And he's got some support if he can find it. He's still there. Ball pops away for Cruden. All Blacks all getting there now. Only 15 or so metres away.
Big numbers out to the right. That needs to go.
Franks to Reed. They've got to keep it moving. Romano, Nonu, and Smith. And they get the try through Liam Massam.
Oh, well done, the All Blacks. It seemed to take forever, didn't it? 1,000 passes. It was always on, but every player executed it perfectly. Every player caught and passed didn't take up too much time because numerically they always had a huge overlap. Look at Dagg. Step, steps, then he breaks three. This could be forward. Marginally, but it's let go anyway. So it's a superb break from Dagg. Savia carries it on, beats a couple. They do very well to get him in the finish. Cuthbert from behind is the man who comes in late there. They can't get him over the touch though. Conrad Smith does well. Messam finishes it off. He is on the end of the chain. Great try, New Zealand.
Well, Savia, the key to that. They'd put a couple of high kicks up his way, and he'd been put under some pressure. That time, though, he managed to knock it back. And how about the hands? You questioned the pass, maybe, Justin. It was a low pass, but, man, he picked it up on his fingertips, kept it going. That's a great team try. And great young Liam Williams doesn't look all that flash at the moment. Boy, that counter-attack has been threatening to burn Wales, and now it has.
Conversion from Cruden is on target. So suddenly 16 points to nil.
Well, you're right, it was a counter-attack, and I agree with you, TJ, but it wasn't a bad kick, but they fell off three or four tackles. You just can't afford to do that. Franks did beautifully well there. He did superbly well as first receiver to shift that on.
And the finish from Liam Messam, his third test try, as the kickoff is made and claimed by the All Blacks. It's there with Andrew Hoare. And now, once again, the quick shift from the first receiver to the second, which is a hallmark of the way the All Blacks play. You'll notice the first receiver rarely goes to contact. They move it to the second.
That's right. What they do is, what they're trying to do with that in terms of the balance of their game plan is make a decision to run at space, not run at players. So if the first player is marked on, he hits the second player who's running at a gap. That way you're not getting T-boned, hitting the chest, balls get compromised and slowed down. you're getting over the advantage line all the time, and then Smith is there like lightning, moving it again, and the defence doesn't have time to adjust. It is a simple game plan, but it does take some skill.
So Warren Gatland back in charge. Rob Howley there on his left. He was in charge for the previous two games. Ball goes short. Romano heaves it on straight away. And the All Blacks again playing the game at pace as Ma'anonu sets it up in centre field. Aaron Smith now, loose pass, but Cruden tidies up. Chased by Priestland, who missed him. Trying to wrestle him to the ground was Faletau, but it's there for Woodcock. And the big prop up to the 10-metre line. Now Messam drives it on. Reed stands over the ball, off to Whitelock. And they just take a metre or two at a time here, just being patient. Off it goes to Franks. Again, see the first receiver doesn't take the contact. He moves it on. Now Cruden, quick hands, beautifully to Savia forward though.
That's the biggest cheer we've heard from the crowd for a while.
I heard a bigger one earlier, actually, Tony, without giving away too many trade secrets. It was the result of a match played a little north of us today. Is it north?
I'd say east.
East, okay.
Yeah.
There's the mark.
So really big. Look at the right-hand side, the left-hand as we're looking at it, that they have here, Wales. So it'll be a right-hand attacking option for them as they're looking at it. You see Jarvis, he's in all sorts of strife with his knee, but the All Blacks have lined three defenders out here, so it's really on for the Welsh to go left, but they haven't got enough room. So Halfpenny's the key. He's directly behind the scrum. He's got to go right.
Bit of scrum from Wales, so Faletau and a little bit of space. Written down on the tackle of Messam. Now Phillips works it across for Charteris. Phillips again. Charging run by Andrews. Off now to Priestland, has a go, but he ran into Richie McCaw amongst others. Quick hands, beautifully done. Smith now, Savia, he lost it in a good tackle by Liam Williams. It's that man again. Liam Williams playing above his weight, you'd have to say. Now McCaw going back here. He's very lucky there aren't too many speedsters after it. It was Faletau rumbling after it. McCaw throws, and it's going to be a free kick here. One of the Welsh players put his hand out and impeded the throw-in. I'm not sure the crowd quite saw that.
Yeah, it's a free kick.
Yeah.
It was absolutely a free kick. He's bang on, Craig Joubert. Faletau was within the 5 metre, and he just threw his hand up and cynically knocked the ball away. Foolish. They were in a good position.
So the All Blacks, well, they didn't really need to try and keep that in. It was going to be Welsh ball anyway. And they're going to throw quickly, Wales. Here's Halfpenny, tracked across by Reed. They could get trapped here, big time. And Scott Williams, so right near their own 22. Wales, as Phillips. Up it goes to Shingler. One of the replacement players who was on in the first couple of minutes of the game. Oh, lovely run here by centre three-quarter Jonathan Davies. Now can he link up? Got the pass away nicely. Here is Williams.
Great tackle, Israel Dagg.
Yama's out. Wales looking for someone to turn up. Here is Phillips.
This needs to go.
They've got to move it.
Oh!
Yeah, they'll have to go back for the penalty. Lovely run by Davies. They've missed him in the last couple of weeks.
There's the difference. Great run from Davies. Through he goes. He's got plenty of players on his inside, but because of Smith, he can't get to them. So he waits. Williams, look at this tackle from Dagg. Round the bootlaces. Brings him down. The ball gets spun wide. We're still seeing the break from Davies. He does very well to link up in the finish. You can see Liam Williams coming there in shot. And the tackle from Dagg was absolutely superb. Needed to be made. I think Williams had Jane for gas. This here is the difference. Franks, earlier on, shifted that on, and the All Blacks benefited from it.
Yep, there
not
were,
Paul James.
There were 14 other players who Wales might have been better served by having on the end of that pass.
And Rhys Priestland's put it dead again, so...
He's made the call, guys. He's in a good position.
He's not happy. He thinks that the assistant referee's got it wrong.
Well, he's one of the men under fire in this Welsh team. He just hasn't been playing as well as he did at the World Cup last year. Warburton's another one who's been coming under all sorts of pressure from the public. He's made a couple of big mistakes, Rhys Priestland, in this game so far.
Crouch. Touch. Set.
Smith clears it off. Nonu first receiver. Crunch, in he goes. Priestland, well, he's lost it, Nonu. Now Faletau on the counter. Oh, he had the man cutting back inside. That was Davis. And Sam Whitelock reeling away there. He might have hurt his arm or his wrist.
Come on, they've won the World Cup now.
Yeah, I agree. I think Faletau needed to shift it on. The Welsh are thinking that they're hard done by there, because when Faletau popped it off the ground, Cruden was a man there getting out of it. Looked like he was offside, but technically he wasn't, because there was no ruck. So he's entitled to play at the ball there, because the ball was popped to him, or basically thrown at him off the ground. So without there being a ruck, it's just general play. And he knocked it back onto the New Zealand side, and then Wales knocked it forward. So again, the mistakes keep coming.
It was good defence. They just held off Faletau, showed him half a gap, and he couldn't resist it, and it closed pretty quickly. Strapping on the wrist of Sam Whitelock.
Official crowd figures, 72,372, very precise.
Touch. Set.
Play resumes. 5 minutes out from half time. Smith. Raking punt by Cruden. Halfpenny. A sometime winger, of course, so he's got plenty of pace. Now Reid is waiting for this, and Dagg commits too. Brilliantly done by Israel Dagg. Well, his form earlier in the season was a bit scratchy. He's certainly come right as Cruden makes a good run. Now Nonu.
Not red.
Back it comes. Not such a good kick this time. A halfpenny. Butchers it. Goes back and you can see the ground scarring up. The roof hasn't been closed all week and it's rained all week. Wouldn't expect it to dry right out. Is taken in by Paul James. Now Phillips. And the kick downfield. Jane, though, is in good position. And as always, the All Blacks look to see if there's a counter-attack on as they shift it over to Savia. And he drills the kick towards the goal line. It's a good kick. It's a very good kick. And Wales will have to throw this about 7 metres out from their own line.
Just see him growing in stature, can't you, Julian Savia? Summed that up really well. Would have been a time where we would have just tucked that. Now he backs his skills. He's been working hard at his skills, catching, passing, high ball and kicking game. I've seen him doing that at training. And it's good to see that just paying off.
Might have a blood bin coming up here.
Ryan Jones in a bit of trouble by the look of it. Well, they've been in the wars, Wales. They've got three replacements out there already. Sam Whitelock's got a big bandage on his wrist, but he looks okay.
It's just been the physicality of the All Blacks. Wales have gone at them pretty aggressively, but they have not yielded. They're just absolutely battering them every time they get the ball. There's some contact on Israel Dagg, Corey Jane.
Look at Liam Williams here, Justin, and this is very impressive from the young 21-year-old.
Yeah, well, obviously, as mentioned, he is, well, if it wasn't mentioned, I'll mention it now. He's a fullback, and he's been in superb form for the Scarlets. So he is playing out of position. Lee Halfpenny occupying that fullback spot. So he's adapted to being on the wing, and he looks like he's got some intent, all right. And he's doing very well.
Well, this is a nasty cut. This is just above the eye on the lid. And I think if he was a professional boxer, they might stop the fight.
Yes. Just hold him.
So Reese throws an important throw and nicely dragged down by Luke Charteris, who is a huge man at 2 metres 06, or 6 foot 9. Now Phillips. And it's not going to gain a lot of ground, but safely enough into touch. Well, 16 points to nil. Wales simply cannot afford to concede another try in the next 2.5 minutes.
Well, this is a position where they set that set piece up. Sevilla's the man to watch. Injected himself around Smith.
Romano quickly. Now Smith. Here's McCaw. Shifts it on immediately to Nonu. And McCaw gets there to help out. Now Smith again. They go wide. Cruden. Here is Dagg. Dagg. They're only 15 metres away here, the All Blacks. And they're going to get an advantage anyway. On it goes. Romano hit hard. And the penalty given. Oh, Craig Jabeer. Earning the eye of the crowd.
I think we'd better give him a lift back to his hotel tonight, I think, guys.
Going under your umbrella, Tony. I've
well,
got one.
Yeah, not with you navigating, though, by the sound of it, this boat. How did we get to Oxford and back yesterday?
I do not know. Penalty count is 8-2. So Wales have been penalised 8 times in the first half. The All Blacks have opted this time to go for the line-out as we close in on half-time. And they do white lock. Here's Woodcock. We've seen it before in the World Cup final. They've saved it up and they've scored it at the Millennium.
Tony Woodcock, the flying prop, goes through the middle of the line out again. The All Blacks opted to take the kick. Look at that gaping huge hole. There was a decoy runner in Aaron Smith that sucked them in. You can see there he's gone around the back, Aaron Smith. A few of them chased him. Woodcock went through the middle, basically untouched. Yes, he still had to do a bit of work just to get the ball down. But the hole was there, well worked, thought out, line out, move, superb.
Well, that's the blow that Wales could not afford. Tony Woodcock's party trick, he's done it so many times, but Wales simply were not awake to it.
Well, get the tape of the World Cup final and you'll see an absolute replica.
Or a couple of tests against Australia. It's not like it hasn't happened before. Wales just simply took their eye off the ball.
9 test tries now for Tony Woodcock, who made his debut on this very ground. Now Cruden, and this could make it 23-0 at half time. Wales charging early, and he gets it through, and it is half time, 23 points to nil, and that is emphatic.
It certainly is, and a great shot of a smiling Dan Carter. He'll be completely pleased with the performance of Aaron Cruden and the rest of the All Blacks. They've been ruthless. They're looking more dangerous the further in this game goes. Wales haven't helped themselves with their penalties, their mistakes, but the All Blacks look such a class and tempo above Wales at the moment. They're going to have to do something special at halftime, say something special to get things back into this game.
The All Black forwards haven't scored many tries this season, but Liam Messam and Tony Woodcock have dotted down in the first half here at the Millennium, with the All Blacks lead Wales by 23 points to nil. So Ian Foster, his first opportunity, I guess, to coach against his old Waikato teammate, Warren Gatland, and Certainly a hit on the scoreboard after 40 minutes.
He'll be happy about that, won't he? Makes the beer flow down easier when you bump into your old mate and you've had a bit of a one-up on him, doesn't it? Here comes Wales. Now, look, I don't know what they've said in the shed, but for me, this will be difficult for them to do, but I think they need to bring James Hook on. I think they need to try something a bit different, maybe put the boot away a little bit, but obviously the reason it's difficult is they've lost so many players already that it does deplete their bench. But, you know, what harm have they got? He's a completely different player. He'll play with the ball to the line more and put other players in space. I think they could do worse than have him on in the game very early in the second half.
Okay, we're just having a look around. Don't know whether they've made that change. There's Mike Phillips. Plays his rugby at Bayonne in France these days.
Yeah, no, Priest and Stephanie are still out there, so I think they could do worse than get Hook out there. There was a lot of debate pre-game about who was the better 10 to start anyway. Preston's made the odd error, but he's not really setting that back line alight, is he? He's not doing enough. Maybe Hook just offer something different and challenge the All Black defence a bit, which is only missed two tackles. Incredible.
Second half underway with Cruden. And the kickoff is made and taken down by Aaron Shingler. The replacement player very early in the piece. There is Priestland, but not a good pass, and already they're behind the advantage line here and held up off the ground by the All Blacks, who are putting some real pressure on here and going to get the turnover just like that. Well, it was a laboured pass from Priestland, and immediately they were on the back foot.
Well, that's just, if you heard Foster's interview there with TJ, and he said we've got to win that collision, take them out of the game. They like to carry the ball hard. They've lost that all day, that collision area, and that one there, McCall was in there, he tied it up long enough, and then you might have seen on your screens there, Ben Franks came in like a bullet. Doesn't seem to be concerning him too much. Was that half smirk smile?
Yeah, he looked pretty relaxed for it.
Yeah.
Coach who's 23-0 down at the moment.
Oh, mate, I'd be distraught. I'd have about as much hair as him, Nisbo.
And scrum goes down, so they'll start again. Oh, he's got a penalty. Now you'd imagine the All Blacks will just accumulate the points. They're not here to please everybody, they're here to win. And that's exactly what's going to happen.
Oh, it's good balanced captaincy from McCaw, isn't it? Like, he sniffed the opportunity just prior to half-time and opted not to take the three. This here, you would think, you can see it very, very well there in your screens. Is an opportunity that Cruden should take, whereas the other one just before half-time was in the 5-metre line, a little bit more of an element of risk. So, you know, he decided that they had that set-piece move up their sleeve. Perfect time to do it. He's just a great captain, isn't he?
Even a tackle, you've got to come from the
left. Well, he first captained the All Blacks on this very ground back in 2004, Richie McCaw. So Cruden, who's landed three penalties and two conversions so far, looking to add to that tally. And he does precisely that. And the Black supporters celebrate again, 26-0.
Cruden has slotted superbly into this team. He probably had an inkling midweek that there was a chance he'd start, but he is doing everything very coolly, very composed.
Priestland kicks off. Aaron Smith waits.
That's just too passive for me, I'm sorry. It's gone so far into the 22 that it's just allowing the All Blacks to dictate the pace and the way that we want to play this game. Wales have got a challenge. The first thing they did in this game was be innovative off the kickoff. They've not gone back to it again, as we see Prince William and the Duchess there. They are keen rugby followers, and they get the big cheer from the crowd, which is good to see.
So Rees throws, now Phillips, away to Priestland. Now they're coming from a bit of depth as Halfpenny gets it across to Cuthbert, Alex Cuthbert. The Wales fundamentally have gone straight across the field, finding it very hard to break that first line of defence. Phillips once more, now Priestland. Here's Warburton. A little bit of space this time for Halfpenny. Slipped through the tackle of Cruden. He lost the ball on the ground, though. Lost it forward, I suspect. Yes, he did.
All right, OK. OK, don't go back.
A bit of pushing and shoving there between Warburton and Romano.
Well, they'll be getting frustrated, and I can see the body language out there isn't great. Preston, you just saw there prior to that, was waving his arms around and disgust at the fact that they've lost this ball. He loses it as he goes to ground here. And you can see there, Andrew Hawes there, as quick as a flash as well. So the mistakes continue.
Wales couldn't afford any more injury problems, so Ryan Jones has had 12 stitches inserted in that cut over his eye at half time.
Gee.
That's quick work.
Yep.
Touch. Set.
Away go the All Blacks again. Cruden. He's finding space in behind the winger. Cuthbert away for Halfpenny. Cuthbert's doubled round. The All Blacks read it. Or broke the tackle of Reed.
Run away, Black.
Wales trying things. Can't be accused of not trying things. Here's Priestland. Overwhelmed by Nonu. Now Phillips. And that's really run strongly from the base at all. Big man that he is. Now Shingler.
No, seven.
Head down, Paul James. They've got an offside here against the All Blacks. They've only conceded a couple of penalties in the game. Phillips has gone quickly and off he goes. And he runs smack into Messam, who read it perfectly. He stood 10 metres away and then came forward. Now Priestland. Balotau. Can't break the tackle of Franks. This is much better from Wales. Good charging run by Cuthbert on the 22. Balotau is there. Lays it back for James. Ball was lost. Backwards though. Now Phillips for Priestland. Lobs it out into centre field for Reese. Again Phillips. Here's Priestland probing. Davis. Good tackle by Cruden. Staying blindside. Good defence there by Luke Romano. Loose ball. Savia pounces and does well, controls it. And off goes Aaron Smith on a little run. Aaron Smith looking for support. And looming up but not able to take it was Aaron Cruden. And they're going to play the knock on. But again, the All Blacks showing how dangerous they can be from inside their own 22.
Yeah, they certainly are. The defence was very good. They threw plenty at them. That ball's just been lost out the back by Wales. Sevilla did very well to tow it ahead and then dive on it. Good, sensible play. Watch Smith dart down the blind side here. His pass, unfortunately, for once in his game wasn't good enough. It was behind Cruden on his shoulder. Look at this. Hits Cruden just on that outside shoulder. If it was in front of him, it would have been better. You can see Cruden going, mate, I wanted that out in front. I was gone. Possibly not, because he was a player, got him about the same time, but he'll profess that.
Played a lot of rugby together, of course, a minute or two, haven't they? Have. Cruden and Smith.
Touch! Six!
So Phillips gets it in. 7 minutes into the second half. Messi. Phillips did well to get away from Reed. And now the ball's turned over. Snapped up by Whitelock. Gets the call from Savia. And away it goes to Dag Nonu. All Blacks will be dangerous from here. Conrad Smith looking for Corey Jane. Pops a lovely pass to Dag on the 22. And they set it again for Smith. Away for Cruden. Hoare. Quick hands. Reed in the gap. Good defence by Wales. Those tackles had to be made. As Smith again works it off for Cruden. Pops the pass. Sevilla puts the foot down.
Oh,
fires it off to Romano. And Luke Romano stretches and scores his first test try.
Oh, man, what a pass. Julian Sevilla, he went through the gap. He had no right to get that pass to Romano. He was heading in the opposite direction. He would cut back. And he just got around the corner with a beautiful two-handed spiral pass. Look at this. I know it looks easy. It's so difficult to do because as a player, you're heading away from where you're passing. So he comes infield. There he goes infield, fades away, and the pass is perfect. Romano, great finish. Shows some strength. Cuthbert's a brute. but Rabano's bigger on the day.
The two lock forwards were out there, and it was Luke Rabano in his first season who picked up a try that he'll never forget at Millennium Stadium.
Well, we saw the pass before from Aaron Smith to Aaron Cruden that didn't stick. That was absolutely perfect. It's become a feature of this tour, the ability of Julian Savia to create tries, lay them on for others as well as score them himself. I think there's going to be a change at halfback for the All Blacks before too long.
Cruden's kick, oh, right on target again. Difficult from the sideline, but no problems for Cruden. 33-0. 18 points from Aaron Cruden today. And just another look at it. Beautifully delivered, and there were a lot of black shirts there. So Priestland gets us going again. Fingertip stuff from Romana, at least from Savia. Tried to give it off to Nonu, but it didn't work on this occasion.
Just mentioning Aaron Smith a moment or so ago, just motioned to the sideline. That knee, which has been causing him some problems during the week, it's heavily strapped. Teddy Weepu has the shirt off and he's on the bench. And looks like Ryan Jones has got more problems. He's left the field.
We're going to play on.
And replacement will be Justin Tupuric, the man who some people are saying should be starting ahead of Sam Warburton.
So he'll be number 20. You can see him there on the blue headgear.
Tony Woodcock leaving the field and just hobbling a little bit as he comes off too. Aaron Smith and Luke Romano also coming off. So the All Blacks making changes. Brody Retallick on in 19. Piriwipu 21. And Wyatt Crockett on in 17.
Well, it all started for Piriwipu on this very ground as well. So a lot of memories for a lot of these players as the line out throw. And Wipu's got to... No, he's not. It goes to Cruden instead. Nonu. He's got a good raking kick on him, even though we don't see it very often. Half Benny took that back inside, so he has to kick it down the centre, and Dagg is comfortably placed. He asks Cruden whether he should kick it. They're playing with a lot of confidence, the All Blacks. Cruden gave him the approval, and he did.
I wonder if he asked him if he was going to chase it.
Yes.
Because he wasn't going to. I'm going to kick it. Are you going to chase it? Should I kick it out or keep it in?
So there's Wyatt Crockett on for Tony Woodcock. He had a pretty severe limp on when he left. So Matthew Rees, 33-0, 12 minutes into the second half. You just wonder where this is going, this game. The way the All Blacks are taking their opportunities. Phillips, Whitelock sticks to him. Tupuric makes the pass. Carried on by Rees.
Push back.
Well, at least Ford has to get there and play halfback as well. Now he's got the All Blacks here for offside. So off goes Phillips again. Well, it's admirable. And all worked down towards the 22. Now the lob pass. Off to Shingler. A lot of high numbers now in this Welsh team. A lot of their reserve players on. As Phillips gets to Warburton. Good strong run by Sam Warburton. Need a bit of inspiration from him. Aaron, and now penalty. Here's Halfpenny. Taken down by Conrad Smith. Warburton again. Looking to inspire this team to something. Phillips again. Priestland drops the pass off. And Scott Williams well and truly taken down. Now here's Priestland again. Halfpenny. Not many get past Richie McCaw. And Lee Halfpenny goes down in the tackle. Matthew Rees. Now, here goes Phillips again. Away for Warburton. Warburton again running hard.
13-1.
Smith. Conrad Smith thought he had a shot at that. Now Scott Williams. Big run by Cuthbert. Came from a long way back, but he didn't make a lot of progress. Here's Phillips to Priestland. Ball dropped off here for Tuperick. And Wales keep coming. Oh, loose pass. And it's gone forward. The All Blacks will pounce. Well, they're very happy with their defence. Very happy with their defence. Liam Messam there. Just giving the troops a bit of a rev up.
And rightly so. Great defence from the All Blacks. That was Wales' best attack yet. Plenty of players putting their hand up, throwing themselves at the All Black line. But it didn't yield. Yes, they got over the advantage line a couple of times, but the scrambling was good. And one of those guys that was key to that and working really hard was Andrew Hoare, and I think he's had a great game, but looks like his day is done, is it, TJ?
Yeah, Dane Cole's already on in 16, and Andrew Hoare getting a bit of raspberry as he leaves the field.
Just a reminder, too, that while we have this little break, of course, we'll be at Twickenham next Saturday afternoon, Sunday morning, New Zealand time, and we also will cover the Women's International between England and New Zealand. First test played last night. England got home 16-13. They'll play another one during the week. And the third and final game. Let's hope it's one all at Twickenham. And that starts at Twickenham at around about 5 o'clock, which I think is 6 a.m. New Zealand time.
Well, one more for the casualty ward. Paul James crying off. And on comes Ethan Jenkins, wearing jersey number 17.
There's the marks, sir. Hooker's left.
93rd cap. In fact, if you add 5 Lions tests, 98th cap for Ethan Jenkins. Plays in Toulon these days. The Wales don't have the luxury of saying you've got to stay at home. A bit like the All Blacks. The All Blacks.
Put it in.
Probably the only team with that real luxury. So Wepu gets a free kick against them.
No.
Wales have made a change at halfback. You see there Travis Noyle, the man on in 21 for Mike Phillips, who, well, apart from taking a few quick taps, otherwise just looked like he's been going through the motions today.
Yes, he really didn't have an impact at all. So here is Noyle as Wales hammer away. Run by Shingler. Now here Noyle again. And a loose pass snapped up by Davis. He's dangerous, though. But Conrad Smith, as always, safe on the tackle. Noyle once more. Warburton has been quite inspired in the last 5 minutes. Noyle again. Priestland off to Rees. Getting rather too many forwards mixed up in these movements. There's Jenkins getting a touch of the ball. Lays it back again for Noyle. Now Priestland. Here's Davis. He's got away this time. Nice work. And he's thrown a forward pass. No, crossover.
Yeah, it's crossing. Definitely crossing.
Obstruction by Red. No advantage.
Gosh, he is a quality player, though, isn't he, Jonathan Davis? He's like another bloke with that name. A couple of decades ago. Every time he gets the ball, he looks capable of creating something.
Well, there's a square up anyway for me. I did say I thought earlier in the game that the All Blacks had a really, really long advantage where they strung plenty of phases together and Joubert came back. Well, he's done the same again for Wales. So that's his consistency. That's why he is the best in the world and why teams really relish having him in control of a game. Wales, I think, have thought they've been on the receiving end, but it's just been because the All Blacks have been too good.
5 penalties against the All Blacks in the second half.
Here's this, all in. Everyone in again. I've been watching the Canadians.
Gonna win it. They do win it. Now what? Here comes the big shove. This looks pretty good. Try. than a back will score on a line-out, but he has, Scott Williams.
Well, he's brought everyone to their feet. They won the line-out really well, and you can just see the massive numbers. No All Blacks committed. That's probably a bit of a faux pas. You know, those guys have to go in. There's no one to defend out there, so there's no point in standing out there. So the All Blacks should have switched on to that and gone in, because once Wales did secure it, they were always going to have the weight behind them with 15 players in there. New Zealand probably guilty of not adapting.
So Wales finally have a shot at goal. Halfpenny's kick is no good. So an unconverted try scored by Scott Williams means 33-5. Let's have another look. Well, it was just sheer weight of numbers.
Well, reward for Wales. They've tried to play positively, tried to take the game to New Zealand. They've just spilt too many chances and been burnt by the All Black counter-attack. That time they got it right.
Prudent kicks off. Handed back by Liam Williams. Here's a good run from Faletau. Bursting away. Got away from McCaw. Now Noyle. Away for Priestland. Wales playing a lot better now. They've got the ball. Halfpenny. Smith Conrad around the ankles. Here's Noyle. Matthew Rees frees it up for Alex Cuthbert. Noyle again. All Blacks struggling to get their hands on the ball here. As Noyle goes again. Now Priestland. They've got numbers, but they need straightening. Ball tipped away by Corey Jane. And there's a penalty. And I think he acknowledges that.
He could be in more trouble. It's quite cynical.
I think he was hoping to tip it up and regain it. So off he goes. And the All Blacks down to 14. He was trying to regain it, wasn't he?
Well, I don't know. You know how I feel about this, Nisbo. He's compromised. If the ball goes to Williams, he's gone. Jane, this is the man he's marking up on. If this ball goes to Hand, Williams is gone. And for me, they've got it right. I'll always stick by my guns with this, regardless of what colour you wear, what jerseys you're in.
Good on you, Justin.
Thank you, Grant.
Change being made in the All Black front row. Charlie Famuina on an 18, replacing Owen Franks.
Well, suddenly the crowd's got right into this game. 20 minutes to go.
So common sense. They've got the advantage in the back line. They have to win this ball cleanly and attack out wide. Sevilla's just on the inside of the post. They've got heaps of space to attack Wales.
Rees throws. All Blacks get in there and try and disrupt the ball. And they're going to end up with a scrum. Well, this is their first opportunity for a while to actually get the ball.
They'll be broken, the backs. I can tell you they'll be so annoyed, because they did have that advantage. They'd work.
Well, great work from Kieran Reid. He was the man who went up and challenged the line out, just put all sorts of pressure on Wales.
Let's keep a good heart, please.
There's Corey Jake watching the replay. Oh, dodgy.
Yeah. You know as a defender, that's the reason I get on that bike, because you know as a defender when you're caught and the player outside you's gone, and you stick an arm out, you've saved yourself.
So off the bat, Reed for Smith. Hello, not Smith, it's Wepu, of course. Halfpenny. Always saw a gap and off he went. Lee Halfpenny, good work. But then Faletau couldn't hang on.
Not even got his hand on
surely
it.
Surely he knocked it on, didn't he? Was
Mark
it not?
Who got his hand on it, yep.
Oh, no, hang on. It's a pretty late call.
Yeah. I actually think Marnoni got his hand on it.
Here we go, boys.
But he's entitled to do that. There was no breakdown, and Nonu knocked it back towards the All Blacks line. So, no problem for them. So, where do you think the knock-on was? You don't think Nonu got a hand on it?
Keep watching.
Oh, I think Pelletier knocked it on. Here we are looking at the try again.
Yeah.
Do you
want to come up a bit closer?
Closer, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, just like the Woodcock try, it's a well-worked, well-rehearsed move.
Crouch!
Touch!
Touch! Set!
So, Wepu feeds the scrum. Off goes Kieran Reid. Good run. Now Wepu has McCaw right there to take it off him. And the All Blacks look to get some continuity back into their game. Dane Coles carries it. Now Wepu up for Crockett. Snapped up again by Reid. Remember, they won back down, so they'll do a fair bit of work in the pack, you'd imagine. Wepu looks at the options, slips over, goes again.
Run away, Reid!
Here is a good run again by Coles. Off the pass from Crockett, leaves it there. And that's a good run coming from Richie McCaw, showing some speed. Inside the 22, but the ball's been lost. Aaron Cruden went in to make the tackle, and he also reckoned he could get the ball back. Now, Wales. All Blacks a bit thin on defence on this near side, but they've got back in good order. Pelletier taken down by Coles. And All Black penalty. And you'd imagine they'll take the three when they're down to 14, but off goes Wepu on a bit of a run. Cruden tried to slip the pass to Conrad Smith. Now the All Blacks complaining, saying he knocked it down. And Craig Joubert is going to have a chat with his man on the sideline. And not a deliberate knockdown.
It's different. The player was actually, had tackled the player who passed the ball. He wasn't in between the two players, and it was just as he was wrapping his arm that his ball hit him. Hand hit the ball. More changes, Tony.
This is Ken Owens of the Llanelli Scarlets coming on at 16, replaces hooker Matthew Rees.
Okay, let's go. Thanks, boss.
Like Aaron Cruden just receiving some attention at the moment. Well, they've still got another 15 minutes of this game to go, but going to be some interesting selections for next week. Tony Woodcock coming off with what looked like it might have a bit of a knee injury, and Dane Coles out there at the moment. Well, the way things are going, he might be the starting hooker at Twickenham.
There's the mark.
And Bowden Barrett. Have a look here. Bowden Barrett just leaving the bench to warm up here. I think Cruden's going to continue.
Set up left.
He's played well, Cruden, hasn't he? Been very, very solid. What I mean by that, I know that can mean not a lot, because he's an exciting player, he's got great footwork in that, but solid in terms of the game plan, hasn't suffered or missed the beat. His goal kicking has been superb, and his general play has been excellent, and his defence, he's nailed everything that's come at him. Right.
And the All Blacks looking to drive over. Whitelock is very close. Ball is right there. And
no, double movement, no try, double movement.
And a double
first
movement.
Red over the top.
But there's a penalty prior to that, number so he was playing under advantage, Craig Joubert. Sam Whitelock thought he had scored a try. But there was a double movement, so that's why that wasn't given.
Gosh, Kieran Reid allowed to run way too far off the back of that scrum.
I actually don't think he should take it out. Their scrum is moving forward very confidently at the moment. I think, and I can see they're trying to work a move, but I think they should go for the push over here. They should give it a go anyway. It won't do them any harm with a back in the bin to give it a go.
So it's a completely new front row from the one that started.
Touch! Six!
Rocket, Collins, and Famuina. Now they've got a penalty. And at this stage, you wonder whether they might just take another scrum.
Hand on the ground.
I think Kieran Reid just gave the ball to Perry Whiffle and said, let's keep going.
Same again.
I'm going to stay this side.
Set up left. I don't want you guys to hit.
So what the All Blacks have done is they've put Conrad Smith on the wing. So you can see him there. That was just his head in the bottom of the frame. He's moving his way up to the right. It's a great shot of it because of that man down. But what it does is just hold the Welsh defenders so they can't gang up on the All Blacks on one side. Very, very intelligent play.
We're going to come closer together. And we're just going to come up a little bit.
Inexperienced front row will be enjoying this. They haven't played 20 test matches between them.
Let's get some hot.
Coles, Crockett, Tamawina.
Boy, I tell you, the 8-9 right is on big time here. If they can get a good hit, get that right-hand side up just a little bit, that shows it perfectly.
Wait, 21.
It's a good scrum. This time they do hold it. Reid. Starting to crab across a wee bit. Now he picks it up, Kieran Reid. McCaw's there with him. They're getting close again.
Let it go, Reid!
Ball is going to come for Wepu. Up it goes. Charge at the line. And this time, a penalty.
He's not supporting his body weight. No way.
And Messam was the runner. He had players there with him. Wales got the penalty though.
I thought he was hard done by earlier in the game as we saw, but there he wasn't supporting his body weight. But we see now the changes maybe I thought should have come earlier, TJ.
Yeah, James Hook on in 22 to great applause as Reece Priestland, who looks a shadow of the player that we saw at the World Cup, leaves the field.
Well, he looks dejected, doesn't he? Looks like a bloke who hasn't made a major contribution.
Going to see a change in the same position for the All Blacks too. Aaron Cruden about to trot off, and Bowden Barrett, who a couple of days ago we were told wasn't fit for the test, on he comes.
Well, what an experience for young Bowden Barrett as well. Cruden's had a good day though, 18 points.
Brilliant.
So Wales have this near their own 22. Savia launches early, dragged down by Liam Williams, who's been a bright point in this Welsh team. Now Barrett gets an early touch. Off goes McCaw, bounces out of a couple of tackles. A couple of good surging runs today by McCaw as Wepu delivers it off, and Barrett's there again. Now Israel Dagg staying nicely on his feet, showing good strength.
Let it go, Reid!
Finally gets it to ground. And Wepu clears it off again. Barrett onto Coles. He in turn finds Reid.
No red!
And tackler no red. Said Craig Joubert. Couldn't resist it, Gethin Jenkins. And got penalised.
Well, this penalty comes as Corey Jane has just one more minute left in the sin bin, coming to the sideline. So they've weathered it pretty well, haven't they?
Barrett slams it away into touch. And we're close to the last 10 minutes where the All Blacks generally always excel with their outstanding fitness. Five-man line-out as Coles rolls it in. Retallick off the top. Now Barrett away for Nonu to Savia Messam. Walsh read it pretty well though. As Wepu feeds it up to Barrett. Now just thinking ahead a wee bit. Bowden Barrett. And he knocked it on, and then the All Blacks were penalised. Under advantage.
Corey Jane back on. And Victor Vito won't be far behind him.
Six.
In fact, here is Vito wearing 20 on for Liam Messam.
I think Liam Messam's had a superb game. Physically outstanding at the breakdowns and in defence. Scored a try, All Blacks first try. And in general, just a very energetic work rate of the game. Great to see.
Tuck takes his place on the bench. 10 minutes left here at the Millennium Stadium. 59 years since Wales last picked the All Blacks. Just about everybody knows that stat. And it doesn't look as though it's going to change here today. Although Wales, not through lack of trying. There's a good run coming again from Cuthbert. He's looked lively. In fact, both wingers have looked very good indeed. As Noyle hands it away. But good, solid defence. And up goes the flag. And that'll be an All Black line out.
In touch, let it go, Red. Let it go, Red.
Okay, all right.
Too late now for the quick throw.
Go on the corner, boys.
Quickly thrown by Coles. Now Wepu. Here comes Liam Williams again. Commits early and knocks it on. Well, it's not through lack of trying, and now he's hanging onto his leg. I think he's got cramp. Not surprisingly, really.
Well, it's been a big day for him there as he hobbles away. He's certainly been up for the challenge, this fellow. He's just a young man. He's tried as hard as he can or could to get involved. It's a big loss, George North. He's one of the players you know can just about break through any defence going. But the young fellow's done pretty well.
Touch! Set!
That's messy. So they'll start again.
Bring it towards me, please.
Neil Ritchie with Gore will, of course, lead the All Blacks on to Twickenham next week, and then he's on sabbatical for Justin, so we won't see him at all for about 6 months.
Second!
No, he will be doing other things, just getting away from the game. I hope he does. I hope he gets away. He doesn't get himself involved in rugby.
Drops.
Completely, A, freshens his body, but B, his mind.
Touch.
Comes back full of enthusiasm. He's in such great form at the moment, though.
Wait, man. Close,
Reed
close,
holds
close.
At the back. Now Wepu. Here's Barrett. Flat kick. Well read, though, by Halfpenny. He's a very good little fullback, Lee Halfpenny, and off he goes once again. James Hook. 10 out from the 22. Travis Noyle again. Now Ken Owens, the replacement hooker. Here is Dupurik. Wales haven't stopped running all day. Pretty tough defence to break down, though, the All Black defence. And again, they give it a go, but the tackle was made by McCaw. Showed him the gap. Said, have a crack at it. There it is. Somebody dying to pick it up. Now here's Hook. Almost at halfway. Lays it back.
Let it go, Black 20.
Again, the All Black defence up very smartly indeed. Davis.
Fun is over.
Change of approach on this occasion. Dag will be happy if this goes out, but it won't.
Oh, well done, though.
Finds his old mate, Corey Jane, who runs into a bit of trouble. And he finds Dag almost playing with an arrogance. And they're going to be penalised anyway. Well, there was no panic.
They nearly wriggled out of it, didn't they?
Very nearly. Here go Wales again. Here's Owens. As Wales look for a second try in the game, Noyle fires it across. An offload. Halfpenny scoops it up. They're still about 10 metres away here, Wales, with about 5.5 minutes remaining in the game. Faletau standing off to the right. He gets it. All Blacks defence well organised across on that far side. They'll look to draw them across as far as they can, then swing it back to this near side.
Use it!
Now, here they come. Charge again by Shingler.
That's forward or not? Play on.
Now here is Scott Andrews, who got on the park very early in the piece. Now Noyle. Not such a good pass. The All Blacks offside, though. There's Bowden Barrett eyed up the goal line, which was still 70-odd metres away.
Might be one last change for the All Blacks coming up.
Come on.
And Ben Smith about to come on in 23. 11. And it looks like Israel Dagg might be the man. No, in fact, it's Julian Savia. Didn't get a try today. But, of course, he did lay one on.
So the three Smiths, the ABC of the Smiths out there. As we take an injury break here. About 4.5 minutes remaining in the game. And Wales have played very well in the second half. Here's the try, the first one anyway, by Liam Messam. The beautifully worked try to Woodcock. And then Luke Romano's first test try off the pass by Savia. So three tries for the All Blacks, one for Wales.
Yes.
And Wales will endeavour to get another one as the ball comes loose. To Purrett, takes it in. Now Noyle. Good run here by Owens. Almost made it. And the All Blacks defending desperately, loose ball. And that gave them a chance to pounce.
Seven.
It's still there though. Nicely controlled in the finish. They've got to use it quickly. And Jenkins in number 17. Now his fellow prop Andrews. Shingler going backwards at the moment. Have to be reminded regularly to use it. Now Noyle works it away for Hook. Davis held up by Nonu. Vito standing over it, couldn't get it. Now Noyle again. Good charge by Andrews. Noyle once more looking to go wide. Here's a try for Alex Cuthbert.
Questions, try or no try, they're just not sure whether he grounded it correctly or just before the touch. It looked pretty good when we first saw it. They did very well. Liam Williams did extremely well here. Look at that nice, quick, beautiful pass. And there's no doubt about that. Cuthbert goes in, set up by Williams beautifully. The nice hands, laid it off, soft hands. And that's try time Wales.
Well, he's been threatening all day. Alex Cuthbert, he's a big man, and he's committed, and he scored a very good try there, 33 points to 10, and it's 10 all in the second half. Wales really been very good value in the second 40 minutes.
Yeah, they certainly have, and it's brought the crowd into it. We've heard some of traditional Welsh singing. And they've got some enthusiasm out of that, I guess. And from there, they've showed some endeavour in attack. Again, some of the players they've brought on, I think, have made a difference. Jenkins has come on and done well. Tupadik has done very well. As mentioned, James Hook coming on, I think, has added something. Scott Williams has actually done very well as well. So maybe some of the changes have just added some spark and have helped Wales.
I'll give them a bit of encouragement ahead of their match with Australia next week here. Trying desperately still to get their first win of the Autumn International Series, Wales.
And once again, conversion misses. ...33-10, 2 minutes left. All Blacks and Wales play seven times in the Millennium Stadium. Richie McCaw just been named man of the match as play continues. It's a mixed reception, the announcement that McCaw's won. And here goes Cuthbert again. Now can he link up? Going to go on the outside or try to of Dagg. Now he flings it back in field. And Piri Wepu is there. All Blacks through Coles. Work it back. And an awkward-looking left-footed kick from Corey Jane. Always the joker.
Yeah. He knew it wasn't one of his best.
No.
He said, but hey, it was off my left.
I think they're going to call the big line-out again. All in. All hands to the pumps, is it? No, they've decided against it. Too far out.
Why?
Well, they were thinking about it.
Why some is of the too far out? Well, my question.
That's the decision they've made. Some of the players wanted it. Someone said no.
Into the last minute as Owens throws. Comes for Noyle. The halfback goes hard. Running hard straight at Crockett. All Blacks, oh, a bit of a stamp on an All Black foot there by number 20.
Well, this is this collapse more law. I think they're going to have a look at it, Justin.
That's harsh, TJ. I totally agree. That was too quick. There's got to be some time where the players are actually held up off the ground. That was, you know, not even 5 seconds, and then it eventually went down, and he's pulled out a collapse wall. I think that's harsh.
His ruling there, though, is totally consistent with what all the other referees have been doing. What I'm saying is I think they need to have a look at the way they apply the law.
Yeah, I'm with you, mate. I totally agree.
It's just happening too quickly.
Yes.
Tackles are too quickly becoming collapse mauls.
Touch. Set.
All Blacks backed onto their own line. Wepu. Back it goes for Bowden Barrett. Belts it into touch. Referee blows the whistle. And the long winning sequence for the All Blacks against Wales continues. As they shake hands, it was an All Black first half performance that got them the win today. They led by 23-0 at half time. Wales bounced back in the second half, but in the end it was still convincing, 33-10.
Brutally physical encounter. I'm sure both teams will be feeling the bruises tomorrow because they went at it. The All Blacks were extremely physical at the breakdown. They knew Wales would be confrontational there. I think they won that battle. It ultimately went a long way to them winning this game. But once again, the ruthlessness of New Zealand. They kept the scoreboard ticking in the first half, taking their points, taking their chances, whereas Wales opted for some bravado. Didn't pay off for them in the finish, and they had to play catch-up. Yes, they caught up at the end of the day, but the All Blacks had the game in the bag by that stage. I think it slightly flatters Wales. But it was great to see them show some innovation, score a couple of tries. It just added to what was a great day, but in particular, a great day if you're a New Zealander.